मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज 11th क्लास बायोलॉजी चैप्टर 6 एनाटॉमी ऑफ फ्लावरिंग प्लांट्स एंड दिस इज लास्ट लेक्चर ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, लेक्चर नंबर 6। टॉपिक्स टू बी डिस्कस्ड टुडे आर सेकेंडरी ग्रोथ इन स्टेम। वी वर डिस्कस इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर ऑल्सो वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट सेकेंडरी ग्रोथ इन स्टेम एंड वी हैव डन एक्टिविटी ऑफ कैम्बियम रिंग। नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल डू अबाउट द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ वुड that result due to secondary growth, then activity of cork cambium and lenticels, and after that next topic will be secondary growth in root. So let's start with different types of root which are formed during secondary growth. So spring wood and autumn wood, what is the difference? Let's see. Many physiological and environmental factors control the activity of cambium. As you have studied the activity of cambium in previous lecture, right? Vascular cambium activity, that how it cuts off different cells on its inner and as well as outer side, right? So secondary xylem and secondary phloem is formed due to activity of cambium ring. Okay, now this activity of cambium ring, it depends on physiological as well as environmental factors. So many factors are there which control this activity. Like in spring season, cambium is very active. Okay, spring season is favorable for the activity of cambium. So in that season, cambium is very active and produces many xylary elements, means secondary xylem. Okay, so in that season, it forms many xylary elements having vessels with wider cavities. You know, vessels are xylem vessels. Okay, a component of xylem. So these vessels are formed with wider cavities. Cavities are present in vessels. Okay, so these vessels which are formed during spring season will have wider cavities. And this wood is called spring wood because it is forming during the spring season. That's why this wood is called spring wood or early wood, right? It is lighter in color and has a lower density. As you can see here, this wood is called spring wood. And this is lower in density and light in color. In winter season, cambium is less active and forms few xylary elements having narrow vessels. Okay, in winter season, cambium activity becomes less and few xylary elements will be formed having narrow vessels. You can compare it with the spring season. In spring season, more xylary elements are formed with wider vessels, and here less xylary elements are formed with narrow vessels. This wood, because it is forming during the winter season, this is called autumn wood or late wood. Now this autumn wood is darker in color and has a lighter density, higher density than spring wood. Okay, so it is darker in color. So you can see here this ring of wood is autumn wood, okay, and it will be comparatively darker in color than spring wood. So these two kinds of wood that appear as alternate concentric rings constitute an annual ring, right? Because both the season will come in a year. Okay, so both types of wood will be formed during 1 year. So these wood, spring wood and after that autumn wood, will appear as concentric, as alternate concentric rings. So all these rings you can see here in this wood, these are alternate concentric rings of spring wood and autumn wood. Okay, and two such concentric rings are formed during 1 year. So we can say these are annual rings. So by counting the number of these concentric rings in a wood, we can count the age of tree, right? Because these are called annual rings. This is used to estimate the age of tree, and this method to estimate the age of tree with the help of annual rings of spring wood and autumn wood is called dendrochronology, right? Dendrochronology is the study of age of tree on the basis of annual rings which are alternate concentric autumn and spring wood rings. Next is difference between heartwood and sapwood. So heartwood is dead, dark brown colored, lignified, means lignin is present here, and central part of secondary xylem. So secondary xylem, which is formed during the secondary growth, in the central part of that secondary xylem, the wood that is formed is called heartwood. Okay, and this wood is of dark brown color, and lignin is present here in this heartwood, as you can see here, this central part of this wood. Okay, this is secondary xylem, and this is central part, and here this dark brown colored wood that is present is called heartwood. The dark color is due to the deposition of organic compounds. Now, what is the reason behind the dark color of this heartwood? Because of the deposition of these organic compounds, it is dark. Organic compounds like all these secondary metabolites like tannins, resins, oils, gums, aromatic substances, essential oils, etc. Okay, these are the substances which are produced inside any plant and which are used by human, right? These are used by human for different purpose, like tannins, resins, oils, gums, all these are of human use. And these are called secondary metabolites also. So these organic compounds are deposited in heartwood and make its color dark brown. These substances make it hard, durable, and resistant to attack of microorganisms and insects. Okay, so these substances are making its color dark brown, as well as these are making this wood hard, durable, and due to these organic compounds, this wood become resistant to attack of microorganisms and other insects. Now, what is function of heartwood? It provides mechanical support to stem. Next is about sapwood. So, sapwood is the peripheral region of secondary xylem. As you can see here, this complete part is secondary xylem. Okay, so the central portion of secondary xylem is heartwood, and this peripheral portion of secondary xylem is sapwood. So this part is sapwood. It is living and lighter in color, right? This heartwood is dead, but this sapwood part is living part, and it is lighter in color, as you can see in the diagram. Now, what is the function of this sapwood? It is involved in the conduction of water and minerals from root to leaf. So, you know the function of xylem. Xylem is involved with the conduction of water and minerals. So, here the secondary xylem is also helping in the conduction of water and mineral from root to leaf. So, heartwood and sapwood, you can differentiate it from here. You can make this diagram by making these two types of wood with different colors. The next is about the activity of core cambium. Okay, we are doing about the secondary growth, and in secondary growth you have done about the activity of vascular cambium. Now, second thing which is important in secondary growth is core cambium. How it is formed and how it is responsible for the secondary growth of a tree. So, as the stem continues to increase in girth due to activity of vascular cambium, right? This is the function of vascular cambium, that it help in increasing the girth of plant by formation of secondary xylem and secondary phloem, right? The outer cortical and epidermis layers get broken. You know, outermost layer in a plant is epidermis. And inner to the epidermis, there are layers of cortex. So that is called cortical layers, okay? Now what is happening? Vascular cambium is active. It is continuously forming secondary xylem and secondary phloem, right? So due to activity of this vascular cambium, or you can say due to formation of more and more amount of secondary xylem, these outer layers of the plant, like cortical layers and epidermis layers, these will get broken. Because secondary xylem will start taking the location of the position of these cortical layers and epidermis layer. Okay, so these will get broken. It is to be replaced to provide new protective cell layers. Okay, now what happened? New protective cell layers will come in place of cortical and epidermis layers. Hence, another meristematic tissue called core cambium is also called phellosen, develops usually in the cortex region. So whenever there will be vascular cambium activity, after some time there will be formation of another meristematic tissue that will be called corcambium or phellogen, will develop in cortical layers when the cortical and the epidermis layers will start get broken. At that time another meristematic tissue will appear, that will be corcambium. And what will be the function of corcambium? There will be replacement of these layers by some new protective cell layers. Okay, this corcambium is also called phellogen. Now let's see how it works. Phellogen is a couple of layers thick. Phellogen means corcambium. It is a couple of layers thick. It is made of narrow, thin walled and nearly rectangular cells. Then phellogen cuts off cells on both sides. So like vascular cambium, corcambium also cuts off cells on its both sides, on inner as well as on outer side. It will form the layers of cells. The outer cells differentiate into corc, that is called phellum. As you can see here, this layer is of phellogen, or you can say corc cambium. Okay, this is phellogen or corc cambium, it is labeled here. So on its inner side as well as on its outer side, it will cut off the cells like vascular cambium. So on its outer side, it is forming a layer of phellum, that is also called corc. As you can see here, this part is corc or phellum, is made by activity of phellogen. And on its inner side, it forms secondary cortex or phellodom. So this part, this blue colored portion you can see here, this is formed on inner side of phellogen, and this is phellodom or or secondary cortex. Okay, so this part is secondary cortex or phellodom, this is phellogen, and on outer side of phellogen this is phellum or corc. So like vascular cambium, it is also forming different layers of cells on its inner as well as on its outer side. Now cells of secondary cortex are parenchymatous. So cells present here in secondary cortex are parenchymatous cells. Okay, so whenever you will show the activity of corcambium, you will make this diagram. In this diagram you will show the phellogen, phellodom and phellum, right? And now inner to the phellodom, or you can say the secondary cortex, this part is secondary phloem. Then this is cambium ring, as you can see here, this is labeled here. So this ring is of cambium. Okay, on cambium ring, on its outer side there will be secondary phloem, and on its inner side there will be secondary xylem, right? So this part is secondary xylem and this part is secondary phloem on its outer side, on outer side of cambium ring you can say, right? And now this is secondary xylem, so you will label it like this. And these rays you can see here, these are medullary rays. Okay, in the center this area is pith, and these patches which you can see here, these are primary xylem. Okay, primary xylem, then these are secondary xylem part, then this is cambium ring and this is secondary phloem. Outer side of the secondary phloem, this is secondary cortex, this is phellogen and this is phellum part. So you will make this diagram. Cork is impervious to water, means it is impermeable to water due to suberin deposition in the cell wall. So suberin is a substance that make it impermeable to water, because it is deposited in the cell wall of the cork, and like here in phellum part. So phellogen, phellum and phellodom, this phellum, this phellogen and this phellodom, all these are collectively called periderm. So periderm is a collection of, periderm is a phellogen, or you can say corcambium, and the layers form due to its activity are called periderm, right? Due to activity of cork cambium, pressure builds up on the remaining layers, peripheral to phellogen means which are outside the phellogen. So there will be a pressure on those layers also, and ultimately these layers die and slough off. Next is formation of bark. So bark is a non-technical term that refers to all tissues exterior to vascular cambium. Now you already know the position of vascular cambium, right? Where it is present? It is present between secondary xylem and secondary phloem. Okay, on its, because on its outer side it is forming secondary phloem, and on its inner side it is forming secondary xylem, right? So all the tissues, or you can say all the layers of cells present outside the vascular cambium, are part of bark, right? Now which layers are present outside the vascular cambium? Obviously, first of all there will be secondary phloem. Okay, so secondary phloem, and outside the secondary phloem, you have seen it in previous slide in the diagram. Just outside the secondary phloem there was secondary cortex. Okay, secondary cortex, which has been formed due to activity of phellogen, right? So secondary cortex, phellogen, and outside the phellogen there was phellum or cork. So all these layers, phellum, or you can say cork, then phellogen, and then secondary cortex, and after that secondary phloem. So all these layers are part of bark, right? Now you know phellum, phellogen, and phelloderm. These are collectively called periderm. So we can say collectively for these three layers, we can say periderm. So periderm and secondary phloem, these are the layers which are forming bark. Okay, because both these are present outside the vascular cambium. These are present exterior to the vascular cambium. So these are forming bark. Now this bark is of two types, early bark and late bark. So early bark is also called soft bark because it is formed early in the season, and late bark is also called hard bark and it is formed towards the end of season. And bark, you can see here, this is cork layer that is also called phellum. This is complete periderm, you can see. Okay, this layer having three layer, phellogen, phelloderm, and phellum. This is called periderm. And this is living phloem. This part is living phloem. So this complete part, all these layers, this is vascular cambium. Okay, and all the layers outside the vascular cambium, means this one and this one, these are forming bark. Now lenticels. At certain regions, phellogen cuts off closely arranged parenchymatous cells on outer side. Phellogen, that is you can say cork cambium, that is active during this secondary growth of the plant. So at certain region, it is forming parenchymatous cells on outer side. These cells rupture epidermis. As these cells will increase in number, there will be pressure on the epidermis. So these cells will rupture the epidermis and form a lens shaped opening, and that lens shaped opening is called lenticel. So this lens shaped opening is formed on the stem because of the rupture of epidermis due to formation of parenchymatous cells by phellogen. So here you can see these are living parenchymatous cells present here, right? And here cork cambium is active, means phellogen is forming these parenchymatous cells, and due to increase in number of these parenchymatous cells, there will be a pressure on the outermost layer, that is of epidermis. Okay, so the epidermis will rupture like this, forming this lens shaped structure, and this is called, means this opening will be formed here, that will be called lenticel. And you know lenticels are present in the stem. So what is the function of these lenticels on stem? Lenticels permit gaseous exchange between the outer atmosphere and the internal tissue of the stem. So lenticels help in respiration. Okay, these help in exchange of carbon dioxide and oxygen, like stomata are doing in case of leaves. So in case of stem, these lenticels are helping in respiration. Next topic is secondary growth in roots. So in dicot root, because secondary growth occur in only in dicot plants, so in dicot root, vascular cambium is completely secondary in origin. So this is the difference. This is the difference in secondary growth in stem and roots, because in stem, vascular cambium is present in early life stages also, in early life stages of plant also. But in case of roots, vascular cambium is completely secondary in origin, means it is not present in early life stages of the plant. It appears in later life stages of the plant, right? It originates from the tissue located just below the phloem bundles. So from where it is arising? It is arising from a portion of pericycle, and pericycle is present just below the phloem bundle, or you can say just above the protoxylem. So you can say between the protoxylem and the phloem, a portion of a layer of cells is present, that is pericycle. So that vascular cambium arises from that pericycle, forming a complete and continuous wavy ring, right? So this pericycle will form a complete and continuous wavy ring, means it will be in the shape of waves, right? So in starting, it will form a wavy ring of vascular cambium, and later on this ring will become circular. This vascular cambium ring will become circular later on. So this is the difference, that from where this vascular cambium is arising and how it is forming wavy ring and then complete a ring. So these things are different in the secondary growth of roots. These you have studied about the secondary growth of plants in case of stem. So in secondary growth in stem, in starting, vascular cambium was present in the form of patches, and later on it was formed a complete layer. So these things are different that you need to learn. Further events are similar to those of dicotyledon. So the remaining things means how after the formation of this vascular cambium ring, there will be formation of secondary xylem and secondary phloem on its outer and inner sides. So these things will remain same. Now this is the diagram showing different stages of secondary growth in a typical dicot root. You have already done all the stages, the diagram for all the stages of secondary growth in case of stem, and these are the diagram for root, secondary growth in root. So first of all, the difference that you need to make here is arrangement of vascular bundles. As you know, the difference between the arrangement of vascular bundle in case of root and stem, because you have studied about the anatomy of root and stem, right? So first thing that you will make different here will be arrangement of vascular bundle. In case of root, there will be arrangement of vascular bundles like this. Okay, so first of all, you will make these all these layers which are present in a transverse section of root. Okay, during the formation of a diagram for the anatomy of the root, you make outermost layer of epidermis. Okay, so this is epidermis. Then inner to the epidermis, there will be layers of cortex. So all these layers are of cortex. Then innermost layer of the cortex, is of endodermis. So this is endodermis. Just inner to the endodermis, this is pericycle, right? And here, these patches you can see here, these are of primary phloem. Okay, so this part is primary phloem. Now, this center part you can see here, these are protoxylem on the tips here on the periphery. Okay, and on the central side there will be metaxylem, which is not labeled here, and in centermost region here there will be pith. Okay, now these are protoxylem, you can see here. Now the cambium ring is formed between xylem and phloem, right, due to some cells of pericycle. So this wavy ring you can see here, this wavy ring just outside the outer side of the protoxylem. This ring is of cambium, or you can say this is vascular cambium or cambium ring, right? Now this cambium ring starts its activity and forms a secondary xylem and secondary phloem, right? So you can see here this cambium ring is had start doing its activity, okay, and due to which this primary phloem has been shifted here. Now in this diagram you will show the secondary xylem and secondary phloem which has been formed due to activity of vascular cambium. So first of all you will make the same layers, the outermost epidermis, then inner to the epidermis the layers of cortex, then endodermis, okay, and after that you will show this vascular cambium here, because I told you that in starting vascular cambium is formed as a wavy ring and later on it becomes a circular ring. So here you can see this vascular cambium has become a circular ring, the this dark green ring, this is vascular cambium ring, okay, and it has become circular here. And on its outer side this part is of secondary phloem, this lighter green part here, this is secondary phloem. And on inner side of this vascular cambium ring, this pink colored portion, this is secondary xylem, right? And this is primary xylem, okay? These patches, these are showing primary xylem. So secondary xylem, so first of all primary xylem, then pink color portion is secondary xylem, then this is vascular cambium, outside the vascular cambium this is secondary phloem, and then there will be endodermis, cortex and epidermis, okay? So all these layers you will show like this in this diagram, okay? In next diagram you can see here this pink color portion has increased, okay? In each diagram you need to focus on one thing, that like girth is increasing, okay? Here you can see the diameter, okay? Then this girth has increased here, in next is it has increased, and in this diagram this girth has increased here than the previous one, okay? So here you will show the secondary xylem part like this, because the secondary xylem elements are formed in large number than secondary phloem, right? So in the center you will show this primary xylem, and then this complete pink color portion, this is secondary xylem. Then this green colored ring you can see here, this is cambium ring. Outside this cambium ring, this part is of secondary phloem, right? And then there will be epidermis, you can see here, epidermis or periderm, okay? It here you will show it ruptured like this, and then inner to the epidermis this layer is of cortex. So all these things you need to label here. Then one more thing is present here, these are annual rings. So these are annual rings, because you know the secondary xylem forms different type of wood during different season, okay? So these concentric rings present here, these are representing secondary xylem formed during different years, okay? And these rings are representing annual rings, okay? Because the, you know, this secondary xylem, like one ring is has been formed here, okay? So this secondary xylem has been formed during first year, then this ring of secondary xylem during second year, then this ring of secondary xylem during third year. So this is representing that this tree is 3 years old, okay? So these are called annual rings, okay? So like this you will make the, this diagram for the secondary growth in dicot root. So all the diagrams for the secondary growth of root as well as for the secondary growth in stem, all these diagrams are very important diagrams. You need to practice all these. So based on today's topics, your homework is NCERT question number 2, 3 and 11, and must practice all the diagrams. Now let's discuss the homework solution of previous lecture. Question number 10 of NCERT, that how is the study of plant anatomy useful to us? So the answer is study of plant anatomy useful to us in the following ways. First is to understand structural adaptations in plant to different climatic conditions. So by knowing the anatomy, we can know about the structural adaptation, that how the plant for surviving in different climatic condition, how different types of anatomy are found in different plants, okay, how structurally these plants are different from each other due to their climatic conditions. Helpful in identifying monocots, dicots and gymnosperms. So there is different type of anatomy in monocots, dicots and gymnosperms. So with the help of that anatomy, we can easily identify monocots, dicots and gymnosperms. Next is physiological conditions can be studied which help in crop improvement. Physiological conditions and how these impact the growth of development of plant. Okay, so these things can be studied with the help of which crop improvement can be done, means better plants can be grown, the yield can be increased. Study of plant fibers such as flax, jute, which are formed due to phloem fibers. Okay, so these fibers etc. helps in their commercial exploitation as it enables to predict the strength of wood, which can be utilized to its potential.